we have examined various evidences for evolution. Let us now know about theories on evolution. In order to explain how evolution has proceeded from time to time, several scientists have tried to give an explanation. Let us examine some of the pertinent theories. One of the earliest theory on evolution is called Lamarckism. Lamarckism is a name given to the theory proposed by a zoologist by name Jean Baptiste Lamarck. Being a zoologist, he keenly studied various animals and the structural features in those animals, based on which he was able to arrive at some conclusions on the basis of which he proposed a theory which is now known as Lamarckism. Lamarck's theory, which was proposed in the year 1809, is based on the following principles. Internal urge, internal urge, new needs, use and disuse of organs, use and disuse of organs, and inheritance of acquired characters. Inheritance of acquired characters. Lamarck firmly believed that in every animal there is an internal urge, an internal urge to undergo changes. In every animal, there is an internal urge to undergo changes. This internal urge is supported by environmental changes. The changes taking place in the environment force the animal to develop new needs. In order to achieve these needs, it becomes necessary for the animal to put into a particular structure of the body into more and more frequent use. So to satisfy the new needs, it may become necessary for the animal to put into a particular structure of the body to be put into more and more frequent use, as a result of which the structure develops much better. Much better. This is what Lamarck meant when he talked about use. Continuous use of organs makes it much better, makes it undergo changes, and so on. In the same way, the other possibility is, in order to satisfy the new needs, it may also become necessary to put a particular structure of the body, into less and less frequent use. Gradually, a part of the body may not be used at all. Therefore, the structure or the part of the body may degenerate. This is what he meant when he said disuse of organs. So, animals develop the practice of putting particular structures of the body into more and more frequent use, or if necessary, into less and less frequent use. So, this habit of using a particular structure into more and more frequent use or less and less frequent use becomes an acquired character. So, generation after generation, the same character is passed on, and therefore, as a result of which, this acquired character gets inherited. It may bring about a significant change in the animal, and it may lead to the formation of a new species. This is the idea given by Lamarckism. So far we have examined various types of evidences in favor of evolution. Let us now examine what the different theories have to say on the possible mechanism of evolution. So, theories on evolution. One of the earliest theory on evolution is called Lamarckism. This theory gets the name because of the scientist who proposed the theory, Jean Baptiste Lamarck. He was a zoologist. He proposed this theory in the year 1809 based on his observation on the structures in various animals. His theory is based on four principles, namely internal urge, new needs, use and disuse of organs, inheritance of acquired characters. According to Lamarck, every animal has an internal urge to undergo changes. Adding to this internal urge, there are changes that occur in the environment, and these environmental changes force the animal to develop new needs. In order to satisfy these new needs, it may become necessary for the animal to put a particular structure or organ of the body into more and more frequent use. Any particular part of the body may be put into more and more frequent use. Therefore, that particular structure develops much better. On the contrary, in order to satisfy a new need, it may become necessary for the animal to put a particular part of the body or an organ of the body into less and less frequent use. Less and less frequent use. So, he says there is a tendency of the structure or organ to become smaller and smaller, and finally the structure degenerates. Therefore, during the lifetime of an animal, it develops the character of either using a particular structure of the body more and more frequently, or not using a particular part of the body at all. So this acquired character, which gets established in the animal, is inherited, passed on to subsequent generations, and therefore this change would bring about the formation of a new species.